Hello children, hi to everyone, welcome back to that is your favorite channel Physics by Imagination. In the first video we have understood some sources and remaining sources we are understanding in this class. Let us learn without wasting time. So now here first one is fossil fuels. The children, these are nothing but the dead remain part of the animals, organic matter, plants, etc., etc., are called fossil fuels. These are very dangerous to the environment. It causes so many kinds of pollution, water pollution, soil pollution. So I can tell that this is the major source to cause different kinds of pollution. The children, if it increases, like you know that is biogases, not children, that is global warming gases, greenhouse effect, greenhouse gases, that is like carbon dioxide, nitrogen sulfide, oxides of nitrogen, oxides of sulfur, okay, oxides of sulfur, oxides of sulfur, nitrogen, they are very dangerous to the nature. I mean carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, carbon trioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen trioxide, all these gases which is going to cause acid rain, global warming, and also which causes air pollution, water pollution, all kinds of pollution. Okay, so now this is about fossil fuels. So these are advantages, that is causes pollution, it is not economically, it is a non-renewable, it is against to nature. Only one advantage, easy to use. After this, solar energy. Dear children, the distance between the earth and sun is about 150 million kilometers. Sun emits the light in the form of heat and light. So the process of obtaining the energy in the form of light and heat is called solar energy. And that is using in two ways. That is, one is solar cooker, and this is solar cell. Solar cooker construction pot, a glass box, glass shutter, concave mirror, and this is black painted box. Now this is construction over working. When the light will falls on this concave mirror, or we can use mirror which reflects and forms convergent beam of light, because and when it is going to form convergent beam of light, it is going to increase heat, and account of that heat we are going to prepare the food. Now one more thing here, why did we prefer black color? Because it is a good absorber and emitter. So this is about solar cooker. It has some disadvantages. We can't use for always. We should use only when sun rays will fall. We can't use during night time. We can't use during rainy time. We can't use during cloudy time. So this is disadvantages. And we should keep on go on change the position of the cooker wherever sun rays will fall. Okay, this is solar cooker. Solar cell. So this is made up of semiconductor devices like silicon, germanium. So when the sunlight will fall on this solar cell, that converts light energy into electrical energy. And there is a principle that is called photovoltaic effect. So means when the sunlight falls on the solar cell, that is going to convert light energy into electrical energy due to emission of charged particles. That is, there is a formation of electrons, holes formation. So that is called photoelectric effect, or we can tell photovoltaic effect. So now we can produce, that is 0 to 5 volt amount of voltage. So here why did we use this semiconductor? Because as temperature increases, resistance will decrease and conduction will increase. If I use metal, as temperature increases, resistance will increase, conduction will decrease. So it will not use metal. So it is again many uses. We can tell 1 million of examples. That is solar watch, solar car, solar scooter, street lamps, lighting the homes, all uses of solar cell. Same disadvantage. That is, we can't use always, we can't use night time, and it is an expensive process. Okay, these are all about, these things all about belongs to solar energy. So last but not least, nuclear energy. The children, what is nuclear energy? This is a large amount of energy is going to be produced due to radioactive elements. That is called nuclear energy. The energy which obtained from the heavy nuclear elements is called nuclear energy. So that energy is producing in two ways: nuclear fission, nuclear fusion. So nuclear means nucleus is going to be split. So the meaning of fission means splitting. Here, heavy nucleus will cut into two small nucleus, two portions. This is heavy nucleus. These are small nuclei. Okay, so suppose this is the uranium element that is going to split into barium, krypton. Okay, so that will be 36, 92, that is 56, this is 56, 142, and this is 96, 36. So in this way, it is going to produce a large amount of energy, nearly 200 mega electron volt. Mega electron volt, very large. So this is called nuclear fission process. And this is the principle of nuclear bomb. Okay, remember that. Principle of nuclear bomb. Next, last but not least, nuclear fusion. Fission means separating. Fusion means combining. So here, what is going to happen here? Nuclear fusion means in the sun. That is the hydrogen nucleus. So this is, it is called deuterium. It is isotope of hydrogen that converts, that is, into heavy nucleus with the liberation of again large amount of energy. Means the process of combining two nucleus to form heavy nucleus and produces larger amount of energy. Question mark. Between them, which is going to produce large amount of energy? That is nuclear fusion process. And this is the principle of hydrogen bomb. Yes, children, today's class we understood fossil fuels, solar energy, nuclear energy. So in this chapter, he will ask you about advantages, disadvantages, and what are the different ways to produce energies. That is, energy transformation he will focus. Please focus on that point. It will be very useful for your MCQ exam. Thank you, children. If you like, please like it and share it. Thank you.